Now, MPs have called for a tax on social media companies to protect young people using social media from health harms. An all-party parliamentary group on social media and young people's mental health have released a report delving into the positives and indeed the negatives of online platforms. Kevin Curran is a professor of cyber security at Ulster University. Good morning, Kevin.
Good morning, Sean.
Let's just meander our way through some of these findings findings in the report. Creating a social media health alliance. So essentially, Kevin, this is an 0.5% levy on the profits of social media companies, and the aim of which is to fund research and draw up clear guidance for the public. Good idea?
It's a good idea. It's hard to see how they can implement it, because what if every country wants their 0.5% levy? But I would welcome something like this, because if you just take the leading social media site in the world, Facebook, they're valued at $480 billion, and their profits for 2018 were $22 billion. Mm-hmm. So they can afford a few shillings.
One of the questions raised is whether or not social media companies actually care. But you mentioned profits there. Maybe they're driven by profits. So this idea that's in the report to establish a duty of care for social media companies with registered UK users aged 24, regulated by Ofcom, essentially. What do you make of that?
Yeah, all the social media companies really are facing regulations, because today it really has been a wild west, and all the problems that there are, you know, such as the privacy, the fake news, the obscene material, the cyberbullying. So some regulation has to be brought in, because we know that damage is being done to society as a whole, and of course young people have to be protected. And again, the social media companies have shown that they cannot regulate themselves, because yes, profit is the bottom line, the goal. So somehow we have to have our governments imposing regulations on these social media giants.
Yeah, and I think anecdotally you'll get no argument really from anyone about everyone's worries about the health impact of social media. I mean, they talk here in this report about the addictive nature of it as well, and whether or not there's enough evidence there to classify it as an unofficial disease. But neither you nor me are medical doctors, Kevin, but it also acknowledges that there is a lack of robust scientific evidence that social media actually causes mental health problems in young people. But it said precautionary measures should be taken to minimise any potential harm. I wonder, you know, when I was growing up, a lot of the advice for anything, whether it be computer games, TV, whatever it was, the advice was always, you know, don't do too much of one thing.
Exactly. And, you know, this is evidence-based research to a large degree. There'd been 9 months doing this inquiry last year, that we know even anecdotally that that online media, that there's a pressure on young people to conform to perceived standards of beauty, and again that they feel they have to live up to what they see. And of course people are using filters, and young people find it hard to also distinguish between that their friends and people that they see are only posting the best possible images that they have. So there is this pressure, especially on young girls, to look like the images are seen, and it's very hard for a young person to really distinguish between reality and actually what is a filter on Instagram and how someone really looks. And so therefore, again, that we do know that there is an increase in body shame and disorder eating through social media, and this has been shown by many studies again. So again, I welcome inquiries like this, and also again, I do welcome more regulations for the social media companies.
And just a final word on the companies themselves. Are you a little bit surprised, Kevin, given, you know, I guess how, you know, Facebook and you know, Twitter and all these companies operate, that they're usually seen as quite hip, quite with the times, you know, ahead of the curve, and therefore on this particular issue, does it maybe suggest that the scale of the problem is something that even they're struggling to deal with?
Absolutely. I mean, you know, Facebook itself is 2.3 billion people, of course, so you're going to see that. Again, there's going to be posts there that, again, they're always coming under problems for trying to take down posts. And we're seeing in the wake of the New Zealand killings, again, there was 1.5 million videos shared. It's very hard for them to moderate. Again, they need to actually use computers to moderate. But again, actually, of all the social media giants, the only social network which has a positive overall effect is YouTube.
Okay. Kevin Curran, Professor of Cybersecurity at Ulster University, thanks very much for your time. You can read more on that on the BBC News website.